a pretty traumatizing mooring ball experience last week, we figured it would be a good idea to go and practice anchoring.
Turn it off.
So we waited for good conditions and picked a sunny and calm day to go and try it out.
But before that, we decided to make good use of the tools of all the lovely people around us to finish a couple of boat jobs.
A few days ago, I went to a dealer and got some solar mounts. Most of the boats they have this welded construction. Right now we have the solar panel attached on deck. What we do have is a davit. These mounts on that davit. Get the solar panel, get the tools, the mounts.
Only
screws. So these are the mounts. So first thing I'm gonna do is measure those and cut them off.
Dead center.
Oh god.
Does it fit?
Yes. Everything on a boat is crooked.
Instant justification.
Now on the truth, we attached the mounts. We put some insulation tape around them because the plastic didn't really fit on our davit.
But we can try. It's pretty stuck already.
Yeah?
Yeah. So let's try it.
It's actually perfectly crooked to the sun. That's not a bad job we've done.
It does look a bit dodgy.
I'm happy.
Me too.
Are you happy?
Yeah. Improvise.
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 So now we have to get the cable from this side all the way to the other side.
That's where the cable goes in.
Yep. Why glad you asked. Yes, I do have an idea. You can see that we have no chance to put it around here over to the other side because we will trip all the time. This is the shore power cable and we tripped on it maybe numerous. Never. We never tripped on it. We will take a cable from here and we put it on the inside of the bimini, zip it open, get the cable through, zip it open again, and then we get it in there.
Oh, that is really genius. So cool, good idea. What's the matter with your feel right?
What's your feel right, baby? Today we spent almost the whole day putting up the solar panel on the davit. Knocked Alex out quite a bit. He didn't eat or drink all day because he was so busy. So he is sleeping it off and I'm going to do a few jobs. The gas is almost empty. So apparently all the stores I wanted to go to are closed because it is still off season. And apparently also Wednesday afternoon stores are not open.
Nothing was open.
Hello.
Apparently Wednesday afternoons, it's not a good time.
Just as Fridays.
We are cutting a mattress because we're getting a topper on the original mattress because the foam is really hard and we need something softer for my very sensitive back. So we got ourselves a memory foam. We took it out of the cover. We put the mattresses, the original ones on top. Now we're just gonna draw on it with the edding and then we can just cut it with a big knife. Measurement tape, okay. Yeah. 15. 16.
If you want to, I can measure this part by only measuring this and this.
Okay, but why? What do you want to measure? If you just put it on top, you draw and you cut. Not much to measure. It won't move.
Just draw the line.
You can't even move it if you
draw the line, Mandy.
I'm drawing the line here, baby. This is where I draw the line. Job well done, huh?
That's the easiest job ever. Yet.
Well, but it's not finished.
Why?
Well, we still have to cut the cover. Ready to go?
Yeah. Today there's not too much wind and we didn't get a chance to practice anchoring. So we're heading out of the Lefkada channel. Keep lookout for a anchorage. We're gonna throw out the anchor maybe 5, 6, 8, 10 times until we know how to do it. We are still pre-season and there's actually no one around.
It takes us about 45 minutes to get from the marina through the channel into the open water right over. Shipwreck.
I think we're stuck.
What?
We are stuck.
Yes. Well then, turn off the motor.
Turn it off.
So that was a little nerve-wracking. You calming down already?
I am.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Want to say what happened?
We anchored first time.
We anchored here in this very windy bay. You might even hear it. Probably do. Having difficulties relaxing?
Yeah, I'm nervous.
Why?
Don't know.
Because we're swaying so much?
No, because I just did it for that first time.
Because there's a lot of wind, huh? Also.
Yeah, and also we're swaying 90 degrees back and forth.
Still that far.
The patch is still the same distance. We sway a lot, which is maybe because of the gusts that make us move like this. You feel safe?
Yeah. I feel safe because the last time when we were on the mooring ball, we actually did not check if we move when we ref and when we, like, when we go backwards. Now we actually checked it.
Unfortunately, we can't see the anchor, which is a shame because I really wanted to. I suggested I dive down, but Mandy doesn't let me. She's too scared.
A random snack combination. Some tea, cheese, nuts, pickles, and pepperoni.
And now we need footage that tells us that we left again. We pulled the anchor up. We sailed back to the marina. The winds were pretty heavy. It was actually a sail. Every moment was a moment when we sailed back. And when it got really then we had dolphins.
The sail was actually not really it was really nice. It's just that the wind picked up at some point and it got up to 25 knots and it was too much for us and we felt not so safe. So we wanted to get the Genoa in, which was out completely, and we did not manage, and then it went a bit wrong and the sail got stuck and the wind spun us around like almost 360 degrees and we kind of freaked out then. And in the moment when we were really freaked out because we were spinning around, the dolphins came. Surrender. And we kind of forgot about it and we managed in the end and it was all good. And we had a good sail back.
True.
I thought it was really fun it was a lot of wind. It was exciting.
Wow, what an interesting turn of event, guys. Bet you didn't expect that one. Tune in next week when very interesting stuff like this happens.
The week went by pretty quickly and nothing much noteworthy happened.